An unlikely winner of a major literary prize. Jeffrey Brown profiles a poet who captured the details of daily life in verse.
I was born in minutes in a roadside kitchen, a skillet whispering my name. I was born to rainwater and lie. I spend so much time in the classroom, and then I come home and it's washing dishes, you know, and cleaning the kitchen, doing laundry, and I don't want to leave any of that stuff out.
Gregory Pardlo is a teacher, student, husband, and father, and now a Pulitzer Prize-winning poet. His reaction when he heard the news?
The kind of cliche of, I'm sure they made a mistake. Well, yes, I was absolutely certain it was a huge mistake.
He had reason. His prize-winning book, Digest, is just his second. And Pardlo isn't well-known even within the small poetry community. He grew up in a middle-class family in Willingboro, New Jersey, near Philadelphia. His father, an air traffic controller, was one of those fired by Ronald Reagan during the 1981 strike.
I remember walking the picket lines with him. It was an inspiring time for me, and I think it was a very hard time for my father because this was his narrative. You know, this was the big story of his success in life.
Gregory Pardlo would face his own struggles and circuitous path to poetry, dropping out of Rutgers, for example, doubting he was good enough to succeed. He says he worries about that with his own students.
Watching that just reminds me of, you know, the little kid that I was who had not necessarily ambitions, but certainly thought anything was possible for a long time until I bought into the stories about African-American boys. And I guess one of my missions, if I can say that I have one, is to have my students and have my readers question the limits that they place on themselves.
Having left school, Pardlo joined the Marine Reserves and later managed a bar for several years where jazz musicians working for peanuts taught him an important lesson.
Watching them night after night and becoming familiar, starting to understand what actually goes into the discipline of an artist, of a musician certainly, and having a regard for, having a respect for how much work that actually entails.
Today, with several degrees in hand and now a teaching fellow at Columbia University, Pardlo and his family live in Brooklyn. It gets into his poetry, as do seemingly disparate ideas and people, the ancient philosopher Heraclitus and the contemporary comedian Chris Rock.
That actually speaks to the title of the book. You know, it said I'm a digest of all of these identities, of all these interests.
How much of you, your family life, your history, the books you read, how much of that do you want to put into the poetry?
All of it, as much as I possibly can. When I have a speaker on the page that is predictable, I think the one thing that a poem cannot abide is cliche. And I don't want the speaker to be predictable. I don't want a single line to be predictable.
Pardlo speaks openly of other struggles he's had, including a battle with alcoholism. He says his family, his wife Ginger and their two daughters, pulled him out of it. And now the Pulitzer gives him a new sense of responsibility.
I want to be happy. I want a life that I feel good about. I want a life in which I feel productive. He who does the work gives birth to his own father. And I want a life in which, you know, to whatever extent my words have an impact on the world, I at least feel like I'm in the conversation about what we do with the society we live in. The one rule I set for myself is to make decisions that are good for my family and the kids. I want them to be proud of me. I want them to be happy. That's a cliche I can live with. I was born passing off the problem of the 20th century I was born. I read minds before I could read fishes and loaves. I walked a piece of the way alone before I was born.
From Brooklyn, New York, I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.